thank you, Lord, for keeping us on this day. God, I thank you for allowing my mama not to suffer any longer. Oh, God, I thank you for hearing her cry. Lord, and I just thank you for Pastor Harrison and the Southern Baptist family, Lord, for allowing these doors to be open unto us. We don't take it for granted, God, that these doors are open to us. And for this, we give you praise. We give you the glory. And we give you the honor. And Jesus, amen. Like someone said, a lot of families, they split up, they argue, they fight. I don't have the energy for that. I'm learning in this season, you can't make people do what they don't want to do. That's not in them to do. And everybody grieves differently. So you have to give people their space. Hallelujah. We get all mad because they don't do what we want them to do. But God ministered to me. He said, I don't want you upset and mad with nobody. It takes too much energy to do that. Because you don't know how they're grieving. And you have to allow people to have their own space and how they grieve. And whatever they did or didn't do, that's between them and their God. And I ain't sitting up here having no heart attacks and strokes and everybody else doing what they want to do. And I'm sitting up here stroking. Oh, that type of party. Hallelujah. I don't have a sad story today. Because I took care of my mom. Or me yelling back saying, Mama, the TV's too loud. So I decided to keep the TV on. Right. Until I get through this. Right. I need to hear sound coming from the room. I'm used to Mom calling on me. I'm going to get to my message. I'm used to running home several certain times to be there because I didn't want to leave her alone. Now I got all this free time and don't know what to do. Don't know what to do. Because when I went somewhere, I made sure she was covered. Called 50 times a day. I can't call her now. If I went to a store, I tied myself and got back home because I knew she was alone. Don't have that now. I had to get out of the house just to do stuff because I don't know what to do. See, some of us act crazy and act like we got it together. No, I don't. That's my mama. She was thinking of everything I did was for her. Did we always get along? No, I ain't gonna stand in the pulpit and lie. Like the majority of us do.
Oh.
There were some good days and there were some bad days, but one thing is rest assured, I took care of my mama and I did what I had to do. And I sacrificed my life and put it on hold, but I refused to put it in a hole. She wasn't going to get COVID. And when she passed, she didn't pass alone. Because y'all know you can't go in the hospitals now. I did the best I could. When I asked God what to say about mama, he said, God is enough. Ephesians, the second chapter, second and the third verse, said, honor thy mother and your father, that your days which is the first commandment with the but there's a promise that your life will be long. It's all about us. We put everything on hold, the marriage, everything. But I hold for mama.
Come on.
The thing that hurt us the most is that she won't see us get married. We cried about that the night that she passed. You know what it's like to go in and shake her and she don't move? And you keep shaking and she don't move. And then you gotta watch her take her out in the body. Every time I close my eyes, I see that image. But understand the fact, for God so loved the world that he gave. So he came back for me.
Come on.
That he gave his only begotten son. That whosoever believeth in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. Now, if y'all got questions that she went to see the Lord, I'm going to help you. When mama kept going in and out of the hospital, I said, Lord, my only thing is I want to see her saved.
That's right.
And know the Lord. Not so much heal her, but to see her saved. Because I wanted her soul right to God. So I talked to my pastor, and she said, Pastor, she said, back in the day, she said, we baptized in the bathroom. Me and Sister Angie took him in the bathroom. Woo! Then we said, turn the shower on. Mama's sitting in her chair. I said, do you love the Lord? She said, yes. Do you believe he died? It is not easily angered. It keeps keeps no record of way of wrongdoings. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. Mama was patient. She realized she was needed in her community. It's so funny my daughter read that, because that was my message. And we didn't talk. So she decided to work the voting polls for a season. She did not boast. She often kept it to herself. She was not proud. She decided to help them serve their community to the fullness by advocating for them to get families the help in which they needed. Whether it was food, clothes, or shelter, she understood that and was not perfect. And in between her working, we would travel to Philly to see my sister. To visit my sister and her beautiful granddaughter and her grandson. And she enjoyed the ride, having fun. She enjoyed the journey. She enjoyed going to the park and watching the birds. All y'all know, we used to ride Mama in the car. And she loved them birds. If I could have found something to put on this casket, I would. Hallelujah, the birds. Living life to the fullest. She loved having her grandchildren here in Boston. Great-grandchildren coming over to the house, hugging her, loving her, kissing on her, and had a good time. And it made her proud when her granddaughter, Monica Cannon Green, walked in the same footsteps that she did serving the community. Hallelujah. It made her proud. She talked about it. She bragged on it all the time. Most of all, even in Mama's sin, nobody has no channel on death. Doctor said 6 months to a year. They called me 2 weeks before she passed and told me she only had, I go back further. One time they told us that she was going to die, and Elder Powell said the devil is alive. And see, I don't know what y'all doing this season, but we fast and we pray, because something going to come out but not. And pray when the doctors had given up on her and said this is her last chance. We began to fast and we began to pray and we began to call on the name of the Lord, because it's power in His name. I don't know my time almost up, but I'm almost done.
It's your time.
Hallelujah. And we began to call on the name of the Lord. And every time she went in the hospital, she rose again. And one thing we must understand, if you ain't going nowhere to go, you can plan my death all you want, but I ain't going nowhere. And to God say so. So every time they went to give up on Mama and say this is it, they wanted me to put him in hospice, Pastor. I wasn't feeling that. And I wasn't feeling that because I didn't feel she was there.
Right. Yeah.
Wanted me to put her in a nursing home so they can treat her like a dog? Absolutely not. That's not an option. They put her in no nursing home for them to mistreat her and pinch her and do all kinds of stuff to her. The devil is a liar. Hallelujah. They hounded me, tried to bully me. I said, the devil is a liar. She loved her family. Her memory may have been up, down, crisscross, applesauce, but I tell you one thing, she knew all her children and her grandchildren, and she knew them by name. And when the little baby would come in and kiss her, she knew. Hallelujah. Y'all already know. Nobody can turn life or death. Only good. She couldn't remember the short term, but the long term. Because she can tell you something that happened 55 years ago and tell it to you when. But I'm here to say today, I thank God for my mother. She was a fighter. She was a fighter. And she fought well. I'm going to miss her. Lord knows I'm going to miss her. And I think my family is a little worried because I've been staying in the house by myself. But I got Jesus. Mother and father will forsake you, but God is going to lift me up and keep me in there. I don't be worried. But I got God. I ain't saying I'm no robot. Don't get it twisted. But I got Jesus all day long. Down in my sanctified soul. Been so unsaved a long time. And I'm not tired yet. But I said to my family, be encouraged. Know that she ain't got to have another doctor's appointment. She ain't got to struggle with her breathing. Do you know what it's like to sit and watch her struggle to breathe? Just to get dressed. To struggle to breathe. Just to sit on the side of the bed. To struggle. Look at her. And I saw her day in and day out. She don't got to struggle no more. She got struggle no more. Watch the day in and day out. Struggle to breathe. Struggle just to sit on the side of the bed. Struggle to try to walk to the door. She don't have to worry. The Bible said he was wounded. She was letting me know it's okay.
Right.
She sat on the side of the bed and said, I'm okay now, sis. I can do this. I'm going to make it. Sis, I love you. Mama's all right now. She got struggle to breathe. She got struggle to get dressed. She's all right now, sis. We got to be all right.
Hallelujah.
I love your family. Just know that mama's home right now. She's at peace and she's blessed. Hallelujah. Father, thank you. Trusted us with her.